First item that will require some votes would be the third, which is the appointment of boards and committees. The first is the accommodation tax advisory committee. We have one bio for the appointment, Terry Stevens. Anyone want to make a motion on Terry Stevens?
Mr. Chairman, I request that we consider and take action and select Terry Stevenson for the accommodation tax.
We have a motion on Terry Stevenson. Second, any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, or affirmative, the pass. Appalachian Council of Governments, we have Mr. Thurston and Mr. Michael Fowler. That would like to have their appointment.
Mr. Chairman, I waive rules and nominate Mr. Thurston.
Have a motion on Thurston, and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, or affirmative, the pass. Make a motion on Mr. Fowler.
Mr. Chairman, I still waive rules and nominate the lit.
Motion, and a second. Mr. Fowler, any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, or affirmative, the pass.
Looks like we need to fill a committee on the Behavioral Health Commission. It looks like we need to carry over again the Board of Assessment Appeals. We have School District 3, School District 7, that we need to find replacements for those two different school districts on the Board of Assessment Appeals. The Building Code Board, we need to find a replacement for John P. Henderson. Do we need an architect, Debbie?
Yes.
We need an architect. So let's find an architect for Building Code Board of Appeals.
Still looking.
All right. We have Community Development Committee, and we need to find a replacement there. Community Development, we need someone. Community Housing Loan. On Disabilities and Special Needs, we have Ernestine Canty that would like to be reappointed. Do we have a motion on Ernestine Canty?
Chairman, I ask that we waive rules and nominate and elect Ms. Canty.
All right, we have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative. Domestic violence, we have a person that does not want to be reappointed, so we need to.
I do, Mr. Chairman. I still waive rules and nominate Mr. Troy.
Right. A motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, or affirmative, the pass. Next, we have Hobbiesville. We have a Wayne M. Godfrey for Hobbiesville. Mr. Chairman, I'll chair that over, please. Sorry. Go ahead, Wayne. I'd like to carry that over. Carry it over?
Yes,
I'm carrying that one over. Bob, we have Lakewood Hill Special Tax.
And Mr. Chairman, I'd like to carry it over. We're waiting on some interviews with the prospects, and we got some resignations out there.
All right. Fremont Community Actions, we have some Board of Trustees that we need to appoint there.
Mr. Chairman, I still would nominate and elect Mr. Barry Denton.
Okay, he sent in a body there. Okay, good. All right, I'm seeing that on here. I didn't see the body. Yes. We have a motion on Mr. Barry Denton and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, affirmative, and it passes. We have a motion on Department of County Planning, Toby McCall.
Mr. Chairman, I waive rules and nominate Mr. Toby McCall.
A motion, second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, or affirmative. We need to fill a spot on the County ULMO Board of Appeals. Ms. Donnie had to resign because she was a little. Twin Lakes Special Tax District. We have a file for reappointment.
And Mr. Chairman, I waive rules and nominate Ms. Sylvia Nichols.
I have a motion on Sylvia Nichols.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. Opposed? No affirmative, it passes.
I will say that Ms. Susan Glenn has, I'd like to take back her resignation, so that position is filled as well.
She can complete her, she was in her middle of term.
She was, okay.
Tiger River, Bob.
We'll carry those over to the next meeting.
Okay. And we have a spot on the Water and Sewer Advisory Committee, and we get that position filled as well, okay? Next item, selection of a vice chairman for our council rules, and we have a new vice chair in January, and so we'll serve on 4 years. So I need a motion on someone for vice chairman.
It's Bob's turn. Chairman, I'd like to waive rules, nominate, elect Councilman Bob Walker.
Second. And a second for Mr. Walker. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? No affirmative, it passes.
You vote against it?
I can count people.
You vote against it?
You abstain?
Thank you.
Friday, our next item is the appointment of the council member to COG, Mr. Brian. Off of COG, so does any of you, fine gentlemen, want to volunteer to do COG? Some of you have already done COG.
How many of you got?
How many of you did?
Mr. Walker.
That's on your side of town.
Yeah. I believe, I'm letting Councilman Farr.
Second. Farr, have a motion in a second on Mr. Farr. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. Opposed? No affirmative. You want to vote against it? An appointment of another member also to SPAS, the Mayor's Transportation Board. Do I have anyone that would like to serve on SPAS? Any other candidate?
I have served on it as a full house, and I'll serve as somebody else.
Anyone else? Not being made motion on Mr. Walker.
Sue.
Have a motion on Mr. Walker? We have a second. We have a second on Walker?
Yep.
Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? No affirmative. Thank you, Mr. Walker. Thank you, Mr. Farr. Next, we will receive an update from the findings on our council fall retreat. It's all present here. How are you doing, brother?
Fine, sir. How are you?
Good to see you, Ben.
Good to see you as well.
Sure.
Good evening, council members. Good evening, folks in the audience. I'm here to give you an update from our council retreat in the fall. We updated the strategic plan. There are a few slides that you'll see to the wall, to the left and to the right, if you want to follow along. Okay, we redid the vision, mission, and values. I won't read the statements to you. We did not make any changes this year. Council did look at them again and visit them, revisit them as you said you would, and feel the vision and mission are still relevant. There's the current vision statement with no changes. Again, the values of inclusion, accountability, collaboration, communication, servant leadership, and continuous improvement. And again, as a reminder, council said these are the values that would guide your decision-making and help shape the framework going forward with the vision and the mission. No changes were made to the values of council. The four overarching goals we're aiming to achieve: creating a sustainable economic development that benefits the businesses and citizens of the county, capitalize on natural resources and tourism opportunities, remain prudent stewards of financial resources and the provision of quality public services, and commit to the implementation of this plan and realization of this inclusive vision. These were the original goals of the first plan in 2014. They are still relevant now. Some objectives and priorities have changed, and we'll talk about those in a second. So what were the priorities for 2018-2019 going forward? These eight things came up during your discussion, during your retreat. Air performance planning, One Spartanburg request, public works, finance and capital penny sales tax, fire service areas, employee compensation, tax bills, and keeping council members informed and updated. And just to remind you of some of the points under each of those that you wanted the county administrator and her team to focus on, under area performance planning, enhance architectural standards across the county. That was a priority there. The One Spartanburg request included continued collaborative beautification efforts at the gateways, litter control efforts, and continue the collaborative efforts with trailways, greenways, and blueways. Under public works, the roads and bridges, improved pavement specs for new public roads, develop improved access management policy for council's consideration, and update the subdivision ordinance, amongst others. In the solid waste area, continue with the 4th Street convenience station relocation, develop mega convenience station design, consider for southern end of the county as a method to take wide variety of waste on the southern end of the county. With the finance and capital committee sales tax, under finance, capital reserve fund, discuss with the state delegation of local government fund. That's on the agenda for 2018-2019, some consideration, excuse me. And also with vehicle property tax, discuss that with the state delegation. Under capital penny sales tax, website landing page, and also looking at the preliminary schedule, selection of owners, representatives, and contractors. For fire service areas, what you want focused on are Hobbiesville, Cross Anchor, Ennery. Proceed with merger details for council's review. Also, EMS staffing in Hobbiesville and Reedville stations, that needs to be assessed. Employee compensation, look at the pay package for fiscal year 2019, and EMS staffing and paramedic compensation. In regards to tax bills, explore adding state expense amount on the tax bills. And finally, with keeping council members informed, the committee chairs will receive progress and key milestone updates, Public Works Committee, Buildings and Grounds Committee, Public Safety and Judiciary Committee, and then that information will come to council through the committee chairs. That's my report. Thank you very much.
Full day of retreat, that's an excellent report.
Good job.
Yeah, good job.
Thank you.
Appreciate that. Well, thank you.
Mr. Chairman, if I just want to take just a moment to thank Mr. Weathers for his involvement in the retreat and with the senior staff. It's really with his facilitation and guidance that we've been able to put together and proceed this plan forward. So we're looking forward to working with him as we transition council's day of priorities into an action plan with the Department of Health. So I want to thank council again and Mr. Weathers for his assistance with our strategic plan.
Thank you much. All right, next we go to our committees. The first committee, Economic Improvement and Development, Honorable David Britt, Chairman, Michael Brown, Roger Duff, members. Mr. Britt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have three items before the committee today. The first is a request to render a first reading to an ordinance authorizing and approving, number one, the development of a joint county industrial and business park pursuant to section 4-1-170 of the federal laws of South Carolina, as amended in conjunction with Cherokee County. Such park to be, at the time of its initial development, geographically located in Cherokee County, and to include certain property
by a company identified for the time being as Project 81 or one or more of its affiliates and other related companies. And number two, the execution and delivery of a written park agreement with Cherokee County so as to the requirement of payments of fee in lieu of ad valorem taxes with respect to the park property, and the sharing of the revenues and expenses of the park. And number three, the distribution of revenues from the park within Spartanburg County. Do I hear a motion that we run first reading to this ordinance?
So moved.
Second.
Motion been made and second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. We'll recommend it for council at 5:30. The next item, we have a request to render first reading to an ordinance consenting to the conversion by Spartanburg County of certain rights of Benor Logistics Systems, Inc. and Benor Properties, LLC, jointly the company, under that certain lease agreement with Spartanburg County to a fee agreement arrangement as provided in Title 12, Chapter 44 of the Code of Laws of South Carolina, 1976, as amended, and authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee agreement between the county and the company in place of said lease agreement, and authorizing the reconveyance of the property subject to a lease agreement by the county to the company. Do I hear a motion? We render first reading to this ordinance?
So moved.
Second.
Motion made and second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries, and we'll recommend that for council at 5:30. And the last item, we have a request to adopt a resolution authorizing under certain conditions the execution delivery by Spartanburg County, South Carolina, a special source revenue credit with Forge Capital Partners, LLC, with respect to a commercial housing development in the county and in the city of Spartanburg, whereby the project would be provided certain credits against payments of fee in lieu of taxes as a reimbursement of a portion of the company's investment in related qualified infrastructure. Do you hear a motion that we adopt this resolution?
So moved.
Made and
second.
Second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We recommend that for Council 530. Chairman, that concludes our committee meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Brett. No items under Public Health, Personnel, Finance, Honorable Bob Walker. Chairman Jeff Horton, Justin Bradley, members, Mr. Walker.
Sorry, Mr. Chairman, we have one item on the agenda tonight, and that's to receive information and take the desired action in reference to an ordinance to add an uncodified ordinance to the county of Spartanburg to certify that Atlas Development, LLC, on a site located at 2150 East Main Street, Duncan, South Carolina, as an abandoned building site under the South Carolina Abandoned Building Revitalization Act. This we took a resolution at the last meeting, and we're doing an ordinance this meeting. So we're unless you got any questions, we're ready to adopt this ordinance first reading.
Mr. Chairman, I move that we render first reading to the ordinance.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
No, I vote aye. No opposed. Mr. Chairman, that concludes our report.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Walker. No items under livability. No items under public safety. No items under land use. We do have a few items under public works, buildings, and ground. Honorable Roger Nutt, Chairman. Whitney Farr, Justin Bradley, members. Mr. Nutt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Today we have a couple of items coming for the committee concerning the Steve Ballou Fund. And I think Mr. Travis Brown is ready to make a presentation.
Yes, thank you. Victor Hill Road is located adjacent to BMW in an area that's seen a lot of industrial growth. So similar to a lot of county roads, it's narrow. This one's 20 feet wide. So this proposal is to take a portion of Victor Hill Road to 24 feet wide. Total cost of the project estimated to be a little over $300,000. Current contributions, Department of Commerce infrastructure grant, $150,000. CTC Representative Allison has pledged all of her set aside in a little over $59,000. So this request is for $100,000.
Okay, do we have any questions for Mr. Brown? Okay. We have a motion.
Move that we approve the request.
Okay, we have a motion on the table.
Second.
Motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? It passes. All right, Mr. Brown, I believe you got another one.
Yes, sir. One more. Lake Wyman Heights Road. So another county road. This road's only 15 feet wide. Proposed 40 home subdivision going in off the end of the road. This one has a couple of issues, a blind hill, which is in the middle, and a sharp, I'm going to call it a 90 degree turn. Just a couple of pictures of the blind hill and also that sharp turn there. So the proposal here is to widen the road. So we're going to from 15 feet to at least 20 feet. This isn't going to fix the vertical or horizontal issues, but it will widen the road enough so vehicles can pass each other. We're also getting striped. Put pavement markers down, so a good visual delineation there. Estimated total project cost $375,000. Current contributions $100,000 from the developer. We've got over $181,000 from CTC representative set aside money, and this request is to get that 375 number in the amount of $93,500.
Okay, this is one of those cases where we've got a development that's coming into a road that's fairly narrow, and it's got some
very
horizontal and vertical problems like you talked about. We've also got a situation where some different community leaders and also the developer themselves are willing to put money into the pot to make sure that we take care of those residents that are already there. We had some, to be honest, we had some complaints from some of the residents out there that their road was already too narrow for some of the traffic. And so we've got a lot of partners coming into this one, so we're getting about 2-to-1 on our investment for the county. So it's another great place for the Steve Ballou Fund, as we see just about every month. We've had something great come up from that. So any questions concerning this one?
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to just thank Public Works and the committee and the collaboration we've got, because yes, there's been a number of problems, and it is a very narrow road. Probably at the widest is 15 foot in most areas, and school buses even have a problem getting down it right now. So I appreciate, this is in my district, so I appreciate the help that's gone forward, and the contractor is participating just like we have in the past. So it's the way it's working.
Great. Oh, we do everything we can for you, Mr. Roman.
I appreciate it, Miss.
All right, any other discussions? Do I hear a motion? I got a motion and a second. Any questions? All those in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Okay, Mr. Brown, I believe that's it. Anything else?
No, sir.
All right, we'll see you next month. Bring something good.
Yeah.
Mr. Chairman, we also have an update. One of the things that we've decided that we wanted to do, especially for our, because the courthouse is in the process of doing everything we can to move forward and make this the courthouse great again. We've decided that the Public Works Committee wants to do an update every month. So there may not be a whole lot going on, but we want the public to know exactly what's going on and when. And so when it happens, come here at 4 o'clock, 4:30, and we'll give an update on the courthouse, and we'll try to do it also again at the 5:30 main meeting. But Catherine, I believe you have some introduction you want to make.
I do, Mr. Chairman. By way of an update, this has to do with the new Judicial Center project. At your retreat, we talked about moving forward with hiring a project manager for the capital penny sales tax projects. In just a moment, I'm going to introduce our new project manager. From a timeline perspective, our goal is to have the architectural design team on board by July 1st. Our target is to try to have that completed by June 1st if possible, and have our construction manager at risk on board by September. So that will complete the project team for these projects. Tonight, it's certainly my pleasure to introduce to you the project manager for this project. The county, through a competitive request for qualifications, has chosen Clear Story Projects Group to serve in the role of the owner's project manager and owner representative for capital improvement projects along the capital penny sales tax referendum. So that would include the new Judicial Center, the Emergency Operations Center, the Municipal Court Police Building, the Joint City County Government Center, and the associated parking garages. Clear Story Projects Groups, by way of introduction, is a Spartanburg-based project management consulting firm that was formed in 2007 by Joe Flower, and you'll meet Joe here in just a moment. Clear Story Projects Group's management approach has been formed based on Joe's experiences as a practicing licensed architect, a certified construction manager, senior financial analyst, executive at a national construction management firm, which many of you may know, Lindbeck Group, a small business owner, developer, and project management owner's representative consultant. So many of you may know Joe's involvement with a number of local projects. He served as the project manager of the site selection design process and construction activities for the Chapman Cultural Center and master planning at both Spartanburg Day School and Converse College. In addition, he served and managed the design for construction as the project manager and owner's representatives for a number of the significant buildings at Spartanburg Casino in the last 10 years. These include the George Dean Johnson Jr. College of Business and Economics, the Thomas E. Hanna YMCA, the St. Paul the Apostle Catholic Church, the Evans Building renovation for Spartanburg Community College, Beaumont Mill renovation, AC Hotel Spartanburg, the Rosalind S. Richardson Center for the Arts at Wofford College, the Jerry Richardson Indoor Stadium at Wofford College, and the design of the Montgomery Building renovation. It's certainly my pleasure to introduce to you Joe Lauer. I asked him to make a few comments this afternoon in the committee, if that's okay, Mr. Chairman.
Absolutely.
Joe, please join us, and welcome to the team.
Thank you. Thank you, Captain. Council members, I'm thrilled to be here. I moved to Spartanburg 14 years ago to build the Chapman Cultural Center, and my family and I have decided to make Spartanburg our home permanently. Certainly look forward to this project and furthering the support of the vision and the mission of Spartanburg County that Mr. Weathers mentioned. Really looking forward to starting the project and seeing it through to its completion, so I'm thrilled to be a part of the team. Thank you.
Thanks, Joe.
Absolutely.
Catherine, unfortunately, we don't have anybody from the courthouse here tonight. Actually, we've got a lot of people from the courthouse here, and I want to just give a quick update. And Catherine, correct me if I'm wrong. The where we are right now is Justice Planning is doing programming. Is that correct?
Yes.
They're in the programming phase, and I didn't know what that meant. But basically, what that means is they're going to be doing a lot of interviewing and talking, and the original interviews that they did basically got, okay, this office needs 2,000 square feet, this one needs 300 square feet, this desk needs to be this. But now we're getting into, okay, this needs to be a rectangle, it needs to have this kind of walls, it needs to have this kind of desk, and the counters need to be this high. This is getting very in-depth stuff that actually will go on paper that will be given to the architect so that they put all those ideas into something tangible that we can see. So this is not a concept to find out how huge or small the courthouse has to be, but this is how big your workspace will be and what will it be comprised of. And so that's what they're doing now. So even though we're hiring the project manager and we're getting bids for our architect and trying to get all that ready, we're not sitting back doing nothing. The programming is probably the next to actually constructing it is probably the most important aspect of this whole process. So this is something you don't want to rush, but we're telling everybody they need to rush. But this needs to be done well. So I appreciate everybody's patience that works at the courthouse, because they're going to be asking a lot of questions. But give them full disclosure and let them know everything that they need to know. And I know you will, and we'll get that moving. But that's a very important part that's going on right now that the courthouse people will see, but obviously the public won't see much of. It's being done kind of internally. But Joe, glad to have you on board. Anybody got any questions or comments about it? Of course, I think this update is going to be very important every month, and we want to have everything out there. We also have a website that's literally going to have the checkbook online, so you can go there and literally see every payment that's made to anybody. It will be fully disclosed. So we want to make sure everybody understands that the website is going to be specifically for the courthouse, right? It will be.
It's for all of the projects related to the capital pay, the sales tax.
Right.
It'll be a page for each of the projects.
But it won't be our website. It'll be a standalone website for this huge project. We'll make sure everybody knows exactly what's going on and when, and be, like I said, full disclosure. So, Council, feel free to ask any questions along the way, and we'll give this update every month if we can. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. That's all.
Chair, I don't know how advantageous this is going to be for the concerns that I know are here, because there's current concerns. I know that we're talking about future developments, so I know that the opinions that will be expressed to you will relate to the actual operations that are currently going on, what we're doing with current facilities. So that's just something I would recommend to the committee to be very mindful of as the monthly updates come, so they won't be deemed to be flying in the face of individuals that have to work in the current condition. So just keep that in mind. All jokes aside.
Okay. Anybody else? That's it, Mr. Chairman. That's all we have.
Thank you, Mr. Knapp. That concludes committee. Does anyone need a break? If not, we'll go ahead and get started with the council meeting. Is our chaplain here?
Tim. Still need to get inside.
Is Chaplain Tim Hackett here? See how normal
people out there are coming in.
Let's take five.
Transition.